Today I am going to discuss a very important chapter, class as basis of all computation. Students, in this chapter we will discuss about what is object, what is a class, what is instruction, encapsulation, what is data abstraction, inheritance, polymorphism, all the things, all the principles of object-oriented programming we will discuss here. And one more thing we will discuss, why class is called the object factory, why class is called the blueprint of object. So these all things we are going to discuss today. So let's we will start first. First question that we will discuss is object. Students, what is object? Student, the question is object. What is object? That anything. See, this is a marker. This is an object. This is the whiteboard. This is an object. I am an object. So anything, everything that you can see in around you, these all things are objects. Means all the real time entity that you can see, that things which are really exist are object. All the things which you can see and that things are exist in reality are called objects. Okay, students? Object. So what is object? So object, an object is a real-time entity having a specific identity, specific characteristics and specific behavior. Students, everything which are present, which exist in reality, they have a specific identity, a specific name also, they have specific characters, they have specific behaviors. So these are called objects. See, why we are called entity? Entity, we cannot say quantity, because according to the physics, quantity means the things that we can measure. So something in the real life objects that we cannot measure. So that's why I used here entity. And it's a real-time entity, means its existence is real. So an object is a real-time entity. An object is a real-time entity having a specific identity. Every object has their own identity. They have their own name. Specific characteristics. Every object in the world, they have specific characteristics. Two objects have maybe or may not be the similar characteristics, but they have their own characteristics. Okay, and specific behaviors. See, the example. For example, orange. A fruit orange. Okay, so what are the characteristics? First of all, we will check the identity. So, orange exists in real world. So, orange is a fruit. What are the characteristics of orange? So, orange is generally in spherical shape, its color is orange. And what are the behaviors? So, its taste is its behavior. The taste of orange is the behavior of orange. And the taste is sweet and sour. So, these are the characteristics and behavior. So, like other object, orange is also object. It has a specific name, that is orange. We will call it orange. Its characteristics is, it is in spherical shape. Color is orange and its behavior is the taste of orange, which is sweet and sour. So similarly, every object in the world have some specific identity, specific characteristics and specific behavior. So object encapsulate state and behavior. So what is the state of object? See, the state of an object is represented by through the values or attributes of its characteristics at a given point. See the example. Example is electric switch is an object and each has two states, either it on or off. electric switch has two state, that is either on or off. It means at a particular time, at a given time means at a given time means at one time, either electric switch will be on or off. Okay, so we can say a state of an object is represented through the value or attributes of its characteristics at a given point. The next topic is the abstraction. Abstraction refers to the act of representing essential features, without including the background detail. See, suppose if you want to drive a car. So for driving a car, you need to know only about the accelerator, its gear system, clutch, brake, and how to rotate its steering. But if I say for driving, you need to be an automobile engineer, so it cannot be possible. So everybody can be an automobile engineer to drive a car. So it is not possible. So I mean to say, for driving a car, only you need to know you need to know about its essential features. Like the knowledge of clutch, brake, gear system, and how to rotate the steering, how to use the brake, how to use the gear system, etc. Okay, similarly, in our previous example, I am talking about the switch system, switch which can be either on or off, at a time. So in a switch system, when we switch on or when we off, when we switch on, the how switch is working inside the circuit, it cannot be explained. We don't know how switch is working in the circuit. We don't know. We only know if you want to use it, we have to on it. If you want to off it, we will press the switch of off. So similarly, abstraction refers to the act of representing essential features without including the background details. In a Java programs, if you want to use a Java program or a software that is made using Java, so you don't need to become an engineer of Java. Only you have to need some essential operating system of Java, and you can use the software which is made by using Java. Next is encapsulation. Encapsulation is the way of combining both data and the function. Data, which is represented by the characteristics of an object, and the function or method, that is behavior of the object. So encapsulation is the process of combining the characteristics and behavior. Okay, so encapsulation is the way of combining both data, which is also called as characteristics, and the function, which is called as behaviors. So encapsulation is the way of combining data and the function in a single unit, and that unit is called class. So our next topic is class. What is class? Okay, implementing object, mean implementation of object. So the object of a real world. In real world, object have physical characteristics. So characteristics means the state of object and behavior. In real world, object have physical characteristics or physical state and behavior. For example, motorbike, its characteristics is its gear system, its a wheel type, its a brakes, okay, and its behavior is braking when we apply, accelerating when we accelerate the bike, changing gears, we have to change the gear during riding. So these are the characteristics and behavior. Similarly, in the software world, in the software object, they have also a state, means characteristics. They have also behavior. So the characteristics, that is state of a software object, is maintained by object, or maintained through variables, and the behavior is implemented through functions, that is also called method. The objects of a software world have state which is maintained through variables and the behavior which is maintained through functions, and the encapsulation is the process is to combining the states which is data and functions in a single unit, and that single unit is called a class. So our next topic is what is a class. Next topic is the class. What is a class? So student, class is the blueprint. Class is the blueprint of a set of objects. Class is the blueprint of set of objects that have a common structure, that have a common structure and common behavior. Means you can say the class is the group of objects. Class is the group of objects that have a common structure and common behavior. Suppose in the class 10. Class 10, all the students are objects, and these objects have some common characteristics. Common characteristics is they have the same uniform, same colors uniform, they are using same types of books, and they have the same behavior also. Behavior is that they are reading same thing at a time. Means suppose in the period of mathematics, all the students are reading mathematics. In the period of computer, all students are doing computer work. Means the class 10 is the name of class, students are the name of objects, and these objects have similar, means common structure and common behavior. Okay, student? A class is actually represents an abstraction where characteristics, that is states, are implemented through data items and the behavior is implemented through method. So now we are in two terms, that is data and method. Class is actually a group of similar objects. You can say class is a group of similar objects, and it is represented by abstraction. Abstraction means where characteristics is implemented through data and its behavior is implemented through its methods or functions. Now the next point is significance of class. What are the different significance of the class? Why class is so important for Java programming? First is the basic unit of object orientation in Java is the class. Class is the basic unit, that is the fundamental basic unit of object oriented programming system. Second, class allows a programmer to define all the properties and methods. If you want to define a variable, you need a class. If you want to do some work, you need a class. Everything in Java that a programmer need to do, in a programmer, he or she has to use a class. Okay. That's why the next point is anything that has to exist as a part of Java. Anything that has to be exist as a part of Java program, that things must has to exist as a part of class. Next is, without classes, there can be no object, because all the objects we define are inside the class. So, without classes, there can be no object, and without objects, no computation can take place in Java. If there is no class, there will be no functions, no variables. So how do we do can perform our calculations, computation work? So that's why I'm telling you, without classes there can be no objects, and without objects the no computation can take place in Java. That's why classes forms the basis of all computation in Java. This is the name of your chapter. Class as basis of all computation. Means if you want to do anything in Java, if you want to write any types of program, if you want to develop any types of software using Java, you have to define first is class. The first thing that you need to define is the class. So our next topic is how we will define a class and what are the different parts of a class.
Action.
So defining a class, this is the general structure of a class. The first part is public class name. Student, this part, public is the access specifier. Access specifier is actually a keyword which allows the access control of a class. We will learn next to this topic. Next is the class. This is the keyword. Class is a keyword used to define a class. And this part is the identifier. Identifier, that means name of class. In Java, this PRG is stored in the name of PRG.java. The actual file name is PRG.java. This is the opening bracket. Opening bracket of class block means from where you can write the statements of a class. Public string name. See, this variable n, public int and roll, public long ph. These are the three variables. These are defined directly inside the class, not inside any method. So these variables are called the instance variable. So these are called instance variable of class. This is the name of function. This is the keyword. What is the keyword? Public is the keyword access specifier. This is the opening bracket of a function, and this is the closing bracket of a function, and this is the closing bracket of a class. And these are the statement of a class. So students, to declare a class, first of all we need to define the class name, then opening bracket, then the instance variable, then the methods. These instance variables are sometimes also called as member variables, because these are directly defined under the class, not under any method. These variables are declared directly under the class. So these variables are also called as member variable. Next is the function, where we will write all the statements of a class. So this is the general structure of a class. Okay students, next topic is the creation of object. How we will create object of a class? Object declaration means how we will define or declare or create an object for a class. So to declare a class, we will use a keyword called new. Sometimes it is called new operator also. So it is a keyword used to create object of a class and allocate memory space for array. So array is our chapter. We will learn it after some time. First of all, we will check how new operator will create a class. See, this is the syntax to create a class. Syntax to create a object. First is the class name, then name of object equal to new. This is class name. Example. See, our class name is PRG. So PRG is the class name. Space object name is the OB. You can specify any name of here. Any name of object. So I am keeping here OB. You can write it OBJ. You can write it like identifier. It is actually an identifier. So by following the rules of identifier, you can keep any name. Equal to new PRG. This part is called the constructor part. This is one of the chapter that we will read in learn in our next video. So to create object, we have to follow this syntax. First of all, we will write the class name, then space, then name of object, then equal to new operator and the constructor part. Constructor part is actually the name of class followed by parenthesis and the semicolon. So this way we will create object of the class. Next is what are the different types of variable that we can use in a class. So next topic is the types of variable used in the class. Types of variable used in class. So there are three types of variable that we generally use. These are instance variable, class variable and local variable. Class variable, instance variable and local variable. What is instance variable? A data member, instance variable is a data member which is declared within a class. Which are declared within a class, not within any method. Means the variable which are declared within a class but outside the method. It is created for every objects of a class. It is created for every objects of a class. Means every objects can be access the instance variables of a class. And third point of instance variable is instance variable can be accessed from any instance of a class. Means any place of a class you can access the instance variable. Okay, this is instance variable. Next is class variable. Second type is class variable. Class variable, a data member that is declared within a class but not within the method. Like a instance variable, class variable is declared in the same way. Means directly under the class, within the class, not within any method. A class variable is declared with a keyword static. The difference between instance variable and class variable is the class variable is declared with the keyword statics, so it is also called static variable. It is also called static variable. It is declared once for a class. It is declared once for a class. That means all object of the class type share these data members as there is a single copy of the class variable is available for all the objects. Next is local variable. Local variable means a data member that is declared within a method. It means variable which are declared inside a method, and this variable can be accessed only within the method body only. Okay, so I'm giving one example in which I will show the instance variable, class variable and local variable.
Sir.
See, public class PRG, class name is PRG, this is the opening bracket of class. See, public int x, this variable x, public int y, this variable x and y are directly declared within a class. Within a class, therefore, x and y, these are called instance variable. Instance variable. Similarly, students, variable z. Variable z, public static int z. Since we are using here a keyword static, that's why the variable z is a class variable. Variable z is a class variable. It is also called a static variable. Okay. Now, public void display. This is the method. And inside the method, we are declaring two variable a and b. So these two variables are called local variable. Local variable, and scope of these two variables are within the opening and closing bracket of this method. Means this variable A and variable B cannot be accessed outside of this block. Means outside of the opening and closing bracket of function display. Okay. Now I am explaining one program. That is question number 51. Okay. So see the question. Question is, define a class with the following description. Student, this question is from your 10 years. This question belongs to ICSE examination 2015. Okay. So define a class with the following description. See, everything is given in your question paper. So the writing of answer of such questions are very easy. So first of all, I am explaining the question. The class name is parking lot. See, class name is also given in the question. Second is instance variable, that is also called data members. Data members. Instance variable, first instance variable is int VNO. Int VNO, in which we have to store the vehicle number. Second is int hours, in which we will store the number of hours the vehicle is parked in the parking lot. And third instance variable is double bill. to store the bill amount. Member method. Void input. To input the vehicle number and hours. In the function void input, we will input the vehicle number that will be stored in variable VNO, and number of hours that will be stored in the variable int hours. Next is void calculate. Void calculate. This function will calculate the charge of parking lot. Charge of parking lot, and the rate is given here. See, the rate is ₹3 for the first hour and ₹1.50 for each additional hours. Void display. This function will display the details, means vehicle number, hours, and bill amount. And at last, write a main method. We have to create a write a main method also. Write a main method to create object of a class and call the above member methods. In the main method, we have to create object of a class and we have to call these all method, means void input, void calculate, and void display. So now I am going to write the answer of this program. Okay, see, here is your answer. Import space java.util.scanner, public class, class name is parking lot because the name of class is given in the question. So students, in this type of question, we have to follow the question paper, means the variable name, means the class name, function name which are given in the question, that same we have to use in the answer. So class name is parking lot as given in the question. Instance variable are int VNO, int hours, and double bill. Public int VNO, public int hours, public double bill. These three are the instance variable. Now the member methods. First method is for input. Method to input vehicle number and hours. Public void input. Students, since in the function void input, we have to enter the value of vehicle number and time, that is in hours. So we have to create the scanner object in function input. So scanner str equal to new scanner system dot in is here. System dot printer and enter vehicle number and hours. Vehicle number is stored in variable VNO. That variable VNO is already declared here. And R is stored in variable hours, which is already declared. So in function void input, we have to input the values of instance variable. Now in the second function, that is void calculate, the function name calculate is given in the question. So we will use the same function name. In this function, in this method, we have to calculate the bill of parking lot as per the question. As per the question, or in question, it is given for the first hour is ₹3 and for the additional hours is ₹1.50 per hour. Okay. So if R is less than equal to 1, bill equal to 3.0. Else means if R is more than 1, it is bill equal to 3.0. This is for the first hour, and R minus 1 because we have calculated already for first hour. R minus 1 into 1.50. So in this function, we have to, we will calculate the value of charge of the parking lot, and which is stored in the variable bill, and variable bill is already declared as instance variable. Now the third function is method to display the details. Details means we have to print the vehicle number, number of hours, and the bill. The public void display, system dot printer and vehicle number VNO, hours, printer and bill equal to bill. So these are the three functions. First function is for input, second function is for calculate, third function is for displaying the result. Now in one important part, this is the one of the most important part of the answer. This is called main method. So public void main. In the main method, we have to create, first of all, we have to create the object of the class. See, to create object, first of all, this is the class name, object name equal to new, and class name and parenthesis. Okay, as I explained earlier, class name, object name, new, parking lot. In this function, first of all, we have to create the object of class, and second, we have to call the above member functions. So first of all, we will call the function input by using the object. Object name is ob, ob.input. So the function void input will be called and values of VNO and ours will be entered. Second is ob.calculate. Then the ob.calculate means this calculate function will be called and the calculation part will be done. Third is ob.display. This time the display function will be called and the result will be printed on the screen. So this way the program will be executed. Okay student, I have explained all the things of class. I will explain some more question and you also try to solve some more question. Questions are given in your 10 years book or previous year's question paper. So you can try to solve at home also. And I will explain some more question in my next video. In my next video, we will also learn the access specifier. Public, private, protected and friendly. Okay students. So till then, bye bye. Have a nice day. जीवन के दिन छोटे सही हम भी बड़े दिल वाले कल की हमें फुर्सत कहां सोचे जो हम मतवा